Okay, in this video we will create autocomplete. So for that we have to put a text box and connect with our API.js VueJs. Okay, so for that let me create a text box. First of all, inside my welcome blade, here you can see I have a left, top left. Here is top left, is a top right. Okay, this is a top right where we have a link. So if I write something here, it will be show here. Now you can see. Okay, here now I will create input type text. Okay, and class will be my simple class, like a form control. Okay, form control. Let me show you this view. That nice. Third thing is placeholder. What are you looking for? Simply, okay. That's nice. Now, if I click here, it will show some input list of users according to what name I am looking for. Okay, for that you have to put here vModel, name it anything, like I say query. Query will be, we will pass in our app.js. So for that, open assets.js, app.js. Here put simple query. Okay, and here now I need vOn keyup. This call actually, when I write here something without any button click, it will be pass the data. So here my function name which I create inside my app.js, here you can put anywhere. In the last I put here, and just alert your query. Okay, this dot query. Simple. Reload. I think I have an error here. Let me check console. Okay. Key up is not defined. I think V on. Is, I think, yeah, K is capital, I think. Okay, put here something. Here is your data which you define there. Okay, that's nice. Now just complete your function and pass the actual value to your controller actually. So for that you can copy any function like this one. You can copy this, or you can copy only this, only then. Yes, that's nice. And put here. Okay. When it's done, remove this, and you will have the data from your controller that you will put in the results. Okay, so this is a result. You can remove this. This result we will define here. This result actually empty by default, but before that we have to define here also your result simply. Okay, and here you don't need this any image content. You just put query parameter and this query simply. Okay, and here you can put your new controller, call it search, and here is your B URL. Let me show you what is this. In the last You can see this one. You can use here. This is, I will show you. Here is the actual link. Okay. And this you can put here this. This is your route name actually, and you need your route web.php. Here you can create route. Actually, we have a post, and here controller name, a post controller. Just put search. Okay, that's fine. Now you need a controller function. Okay. In the controller, post controller, you will add search function anywhere. Let me put after the index function search function, and here you will put request and request. Yes, here just say I am getting the request query. Okay, that we will can see in the console also. Okay, let me say console dot log. Here you can put response, that's fine. Reload. Now put your value, and I have a 404 error. Okay, I forget to add here slash actually. Reload, put here something, and you will get some data here is query. Okay, what you are enter here. Let me add the check the last you getting this your value. Okay, now you want to show your user list. For that you have to update the result. So for that, let's put this in the variable query, and here you will say users. Let's say user have a user, this one, and first of all let me fetch all user data and return this reload. Now we can see in the console array of the list your user data. Now here is your user. Let me show inside the network. Here is your all user. What I need according to what I add here. Okay, so for that you will add a let me say db. Table name is users, and my where condition some contain name parameters like a like and percentage sign. Actually this is for your parameter which we are passing there. This query will get data which name we are trying to search, and the last get according to name, that's fine. Now reload. Now we will check inside the network. Put here Anita, I mean Anita, and check here. Here is name of Anita. You can see. Let me add HA. The last you can see is name. So that we have to display there. Here after this we will create a new div, class it panel footer that is Bootstrap class actually, and inside you will say we if result dot length. This is for if result is not empty, and inside here you will start for loop for result in results. Result contain a array which I show you here. Let me show you. Here is the result array. So we put here result. You can put here user name, anything. I use result, and here you can add and result dot name, anything you can display it. Let me show you. If I put here HAR is the backside, I will show you. Let me hide this hidden ID. Okay, starting mistake. Reload. Now you will see the result here. Put any name here. You can see only H. This is the our result auto complete our user, same like our Facebook. Okay, to make it Z index, so you have to put this div a style. First of all, position relative, and second Z index 1000. Reload. Now you can see on the top this list. Yeah, that's it. I need more look different, like a footer 1 pixel solid 333, and background color I need white. Here you can put gray, light gray, and you can add padding, but now I just add here D tag. Let me see what is the difference of design. Here you will put any name, and here is your result. That's nice. Okay, if I say slug, we have a here is link, profile link. Okay, just copy this. Okay, and put here anchor tag. Inside this you will change this according to your result. Actually here you will put your result. Okay, so for now I just put it according to profile. That's it. If I put here, it will show profile link according to my. So this was our autocomplete. It will be countable, like only A have a common everything. This is K, this is also K. If I put here K, it show all K. So that's one our autocomplete. I hope this video will help you everywhere. You can put anything like a city, everything you can put here. Okay, so thank you. See you in the next video. Thank you guys.